Hello there! In this quick video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make your own animated GIFs in Photoshop. I open up Photoshop and I'm creating a new document. I sized it to Instagram square size, so 1080 pixel by 1080 pixel, 72 dpi RGB color. I do so because I don't really need a bigger animated GIF. I'm going to later add this to my Instagram stories, and the width is just the perfect size for that purpose. So I press on create. So my file opened, and as you can see, it made an artboard. This is a new feature in the latest Photoshop Creative Cloud version, and we don't need this artboard setup, so I just click here and ungroup artboards. We just need a simple layer. So this will be our background. I name it background VG. And I fill it with white. And then I open up my folder because I will copy here, I will paste here my PNG illustration elements. So I have a few elements here from one of my new products. And this is what I'm going to use to create my animated GIF. I insert this one. This flower, I insert this leaf, this smaller flower, and this little berry looking element. So when I have all my elements, I just center it a little bit. And I'm going to add some text. Maybe I add one more element here. Okay, so then I click on the type tool or press T and write here my text. I want to make it a different color, so I pick this gray color from the illustration, and I like the look of it, so now I'm going to group these layers. I group everything from the background till the text, so everything. And as you can see, all my flowers were inserted as smart object layers. This is important for future steps. So make sure that they have this little icon here in the corner of the layer thumbnail. That means that this is a smart object file. So So I just select all of them from the background to the text, and I can group them, or I can just go and make them into one smart object. So convert to smart object, and the name is fine as it is for now. Then I go into Window and open up the timeline panel. It opens up at the bottom. And I want to make a frame animation, not a timeline animation. The timeline animation has more features and it's a more sophisticated tool. We will go with frame animation, which is pretty basic. So click on frame animation. And as you can see, right now we have just one frame. And it's even set to just 0 seconds. So I set it to 0.2 seconds. If I want to add a new frame, I can click on this little icon here. And as you can see, it adds a new frame. So right now there's no difference between the two frames. Both of has shows the same thing. But I can copy this smart object layer, make some changes, and tell Photoshop that the second frame should show the modified smart object. So I right click on the layer and say new smart object via copy. This is important to copy it like this, because if I copy it the regular way, every change that I make in the smart object will be visible on the copies too. So I click on new smart object via copy and it opens up. It copies my smart object. I will name it in bloom 2. The first one is in bloom 1. This will be what the first frame shows and this will be what the second frame shows. So when I'm on the first frame, only the first layer should be shown. So only that has the little eye icon. So only the second smart object should be shown. Now I go into the second smart object in Bloom 2 by double clicking on the thumbnail. It opens up in a new tab. And now I can make changes. So what I decided is to change the color of the text. I click here and I make it into this green. Then I save it, file, save, and close it. Now, if I start to play it, you will see that it jumps between the two frames and makes a very, very simple animation. I stop it. I can also do changes on the flowers. So I go into in Bloom 2 and move the flowers a little bit around. So I have my selection tool and I check mark the auto select. So when I click on a layer, it will select automatically its layer. So I click on this flower, press Command T or Control T on Windows, and I just move it a bit around. Then let's move this around the leaf, Command T. Then this one. Then this little flower. I go totally random for now with the movement and the rotation angle. You can set up it however you want. You can change their rotation or position, but don't make too big changes, just slight changes. I need this one. Okay, so I changed all of them and I press Command S or Control S to save it and close it. And now when I play it, it jumps around. Okay, so I went ahead and I set up several more smart objects and made them into the frames. So the first smart object is on the first frame, the second smart object only visible on the second frame, the third one is on the third frame, fourth one is on the fourth frame, and the fifth one is on the fifth frame. So, and as you can see, my little floral elements gradually move out. I also go in and, because my first frame is in gray and the font, a second frame is turquoise, and I make the third frame, I make it into light turquoise. I save it, close it, and then on the fourth one it's again turquoise, and on the fifth one it's going to be gray again. So now my animation looks like this. But I don't like the sudden jump that happens between frame 5 and frame 1. I want it to gradually, and the flowers to gradually go back. So I don't have to make new layers for this. I can just add new frames and change the order. So the frame number 6 will show the fourth smart object. New frame, frame number 7 will show the third one. Frame number 8 is going to show the second one, and then we return to number 1. So let's see how it looks. When you're satisfied with your animation, you can export your file to an animated GIF format. Just go to File, Export, Save for Web Legacy, and here choose the GIF file format. Leave the colors at the maximum 256, and then just click on Save and save it to your computer. You can also change here the size and the quality. If you plan to create this animated GIF as an Instagram story sticker, it's better to go without a background. In this case, you can go into your smart objects and just make the background invisible. Save it as it is. And do the same for the rest of the smart object layers. When you save your file, just do the same as we did before. Go to File, Export, Save for Web Legacy, and choose the GIF format. That way, you can also save on a transparent background. So this was my very quick tutorial showing you how to use frame animation in Photoshop to create animated GIFs for your brand. I hope you really liked this video, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask them in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and see you next week.